Hey everybody, this is your Wednesday lesson. I hope everybody got their activity sheets on Sunday. We're learning about Zacchaeus this week. You've probably heard the song, Zacchaeus Was a Wee Little Man. If you haven't heard that song, get your mom and dad to look that up for you this week so you can learn to sing it. We're going to start reading today in Luke chapter 19. We're going to read verses 1 through 10 and learn about Zacchaeus. Okay, now it says that Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being a short man, he could not because of the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, "He has gone to be the guest of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost." So there's lots of little parts in this story about Zacchaeus. Now some people say Zacchaeus. I learned to say Zacchaeus because of that song, singing it with the boys when they were little. But as we go through these verses, we learn that Zacchaeus was a tax collector. And because he was a tax collector, he was not very popular with the people. You know, they were probably saying pretty mean things to him, maybe calling him mean names, you know. And when he wanted to see Jesus, he had to get around that crowd. There was a crowd of people in his way of seeing Jesus. And those people, you know, they weren't his friends, they weren't nice to him, but he had to learn how to get around them so that he could see Jesus. That was the main thing on his mind, was being able to see Jesus. Now we learn at the end of the story that he says that he's gonna give all his possessions to the poor. After he saw Jesus, he was a changed man. He wanted to be forgiven, he wanted to give back to people what he had cheated them out of, and even more than he had cheated them out of. But the main thing I wanted to focus on today is what Zacchaeus went through to find Jesus, okay? So I want you to think of yourself and think if there's anything standing in your way of seeing Jesus. Is there any distractions in your life that's keeping you from seeing Jesus, from finding him? You know, TV can be a distraction, games can be a distraction, our phones, sports, anything in this world can be a distraction to keep our eyes off Jesus. Now, I'm not saying that we have to sit down and read our Bibles 24 hours a day to keep our minds on Jesus and keep our eyes on him. I'm saying that we should always be in conversation with him. Always know that your best friend is right there with you, ready to listen to you, and he wants you to find him. And if we look at the last verse here, verse 10, it says, "For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost." So just as you're looking for Jesus, he's looking for you. He always wants you to find him whenever you need him, whenever you have a decision to make, whenever you just need to talk to somebody, he wants you to seek him and find him. Now, as you're thinking this week of some of those distractions that might get in the way, I want you to think of Zacchaeus. You know, he was a short man. He wasn't tall in stature, and he had to figure out a way to see Jesus. So I want you to think what you can do to climb over some of these distractions. Like he had to climb that tree. I want you guys to think of some distractions that you need to climb over this week to find him, to find time to spend with him and to draw closer with him. Now this Sunday, we get to have Graduate Sunday, and we get to celebrate four lovely ladies that, you know, are so special to me, all four of them. I've got to watch all four of them grow up, some of them from babies, really, just when they were little girls. And we're really excited to celebrate Abby and Hannah and Olivia and Mackenzie. And that made me think of a science experiment that I'm doing with Zeke this week. We started growing caterpillars into butterflies. So I wanted to share that with you today. We have got, I don't know if you can see them. You might can see two hanging right there, but they are getting ready to turn into their chrysalis. I've had one turn into a chrysalis and he's fallen to the bottom. So I hope that one still makes it, but we've got two hanging and two getting ready to start hanging. So it says in about 7 to 10 days that they will have their chrysalis completely formed and they'll start turning into butterflies. And as we watch these girls turn into butterflies as well, as they've all grown up and we've watched them mature in their faith and just become such lovely people, that we just want to celebrate them this Sunday. As you watch our video next week, I hope to show you something different going on with our caterpillars, and hopefully we'll get to see some butterflies even the next week. But I've enjoyed getting to talk to you guys today. I hope you've enjoyed your lesson. I'll have some more activity sheets for you on Sunday. Your Bible verse to memorize for me if you want to send in for Grace Books is Luke chapter 19, it's verse 10. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost. So just always remember that he is seeking you. And please don't forget to seek him. Love you guys. Bye.